Seats. Excellent. Hopefully everybody got your orchestra tickets taken care of. If not, you can see us after. So really, really excited. I mean, this next guest needs no introduction. But first time I played for Joseph Alessi was actually my freshman, sophomore year of undergrad. And it was life-changing. And I'm so excited he's here, that you all get to hear him play today and teach some. The program is in your folder, and there is a slight change. He's going to be playing an unaccompanied piece as well as the Gershwin. So please help me welcome Maestro Joseph Alessi.
So anyway, Ellen Elder is going to come out. We'll welcome her. Thank you very much. I'm not looking for any sympathy here, but I just wanted to tell you I was supposed to be playing a lot of material here, and some of you know this, but anyway, I was afflicted on Thanksgiving, around Thanksgiving, with this thing called Bell's palsy, okay, and some very good friends of mine have had this. It's a medical syndrome, and Charlie Vernon has gone through it. And my colleague David Finlayson has gone through it. And anyway, I hope you never get it, but if you do, call me, and I can help you through it. And it seems like you know, there's no hope when you first get it, because you can't make an embouchure, or you know, it's. I won't go into the gory details, but there's you lose control of your face. Okay, so so I was just stripped of my playing all of a sudden, so this is the first, you know, big performance I've done. So I think I'm on my way back. You know, so just it's yeah. So the way to get back is very interesting. If you took a lot of time off, I would recommend this method actually of getting back. Or if you lose control of anything, there's exercises that by a doctor in Spain that were given to me, and this doctor's office over there treated my other friend, who had the same affliction I did 1 month before I did. And he plays first trombone in La Scala, Daniele Morandini. So he helped me tremendously. And he sent me to this doctor. And this office only deals with musicians' injuries, dancer injuries, and actors. Okay, I'm not sure about what they do for actors, but anyway. so anyway, it really helped. I did the exercises religiously, and I got acupuncture. You know, I did everything I could to get myself back. And let's see, what else did I do? You know, obviously the medicine that you're supposed to take for that. And anyway, it slowly came back. And so now, enough of that. Let's get on with the teaching part of this. And thank you for, I hope you're having a good time here. We have to thank Shires and Greg Black and all the people who sponsored this event. And okay, who is the first victim? Yeah. Oh, here we go. That was a joke, of course. Yeah. Okay, no, it's Caleb. Caleb?
Yes, sir.
See, I recognize you through the mask.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, Caleb, what are you going to play?
I'm going to play the first and second movement of the Corrado Maria Sagliati Alto Trombone Suite.
Okay, why don't you come over here? I'll just put this here.
Thank you.
I like if you can smile right after that last note. And then add a little, you know, that was good. Okay. So let's talk about the mute, okay? Because that's unusual to be playing with. It's an alto trombone mute. But when you play with an alto, when you play with any mute, you have to play with a little bit more compression and a little bit louder.
Okay.
It doesn't have the instantaneous sound and rhythm to it.
Sure.
Can you just do the alto part? I'm sorry, the mute part by yourself. Just let me hear that. So, is it F sharp?
It is.
Okay.
Really get the compression. Okay. But even more. Yeah. Exactly. You have to hit it squarely. Otherwise, it'll have a little burble in there.
Sure.
Okay. But can I play the whole thing? See, some notes you're not hitting squarely.
I agree.
Okay, let's try with the piano. It's a chromaticism, right?
think you have to come down. So.
too soft too soon. So,
yeah. Oh, is there a dynamic change?
There it is.
Oh, it's right away. But I think after that, it doesn't. There's no law against, you know, doing something with the thing. So I'll just play this.
Sure.
Thank you, Ellen. Okay, so we worked on some of this in the other class, right?
Yes.
Can we work on the other part of it? Is that all right?
The back half?
Yes.
Yes.
So, let's start it.
It was another student that worked on the beginning half.
I thought it was a squirrel. Okay, good. I'm glad we had the pianist. That's great. Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
Lake. Let's call me Lake.
Okay. Yeah. Nice to meet you,
nice Lake. Nice to meet you.
Okay. Flat chord, and this major, yes, and this is what I do, so you can repeat it. Go ahead. Two fortes,
harmony sounds better when there's decay. Okay, so if you sit on a note for too long, it gets that car horn syndrome thing happens. No, I mean, it's true, because it's just like this, and it gets, you know.
You have to think how to be more pleasing.
Yeah. Play dramatically, but also let it have, your notes have some flexibility. Okay, now, can I hear you play this? Yeah, so when you do that G crescendo, first of all, there's no crescendo on that G, right?
Yes.
So you're really, so it should be. Right, make the crescendo there.
Okay.
Let's start here again, just without piano. Great. threshold right there. If you go any faster than that, it doesn't hold up. But you have to spend time at that speed with that exercise. One more chance. Give me one more chance at that speed. After that. Now has a diminuendo. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think you could come way down there, so. Sit back with the score and just start, take your pencil and start marking arrows where your tendency, so you start to learn intonation on the instrument. You don't continue to play out of tune. Nothing gets better, right? So, right here. Speak immediately.
Yes.
Try again.
are you?
I'm good. Nervous.
You're playing Tetra Urna by Donald Black.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
You wait, Tom.
Should not be connected. So every time the tongue moves, the arm should move. really stay, you could really work on that. So if you move around, the more moving parts that happen in your playing, okay, the more that can go on. So you have to just do target practice.
Thank you.
sound. That's what I'm hearing. Right there, continue.
Starting.
smoke and mirrors. Okay, so. See, I stopped moving. If you sit there and move like this, you're going to break something. Okay, so. For everybody, but everybody has to work on their technique, you know. However, you can use musical solutions, okay, that will fix some of that stuff as well. So that's kind of what the way I'm working with you today. We're trying to find a musical solution and see if we can, you know, with pitch and. The only real technical thing I've said is about, you know, the trill and also the staccato.
Yeah.
Okay. There you go. Okay, we heard this part, sorry.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah, let's go to the ending.
L starts
out. L. Yep. Okay, thank you. it for different pitches, but in your case, you were letting go of it, and then you have to grab onto it again.
Yeah.
And then that's why you miss some of the notes.
Sure.
Okay. Giving the ending away at all. You know, so. Okay, bravo. Nice job.